Hello everyone, in this video we are just going to build our first project on IoT using our NodeMCU and ThingSpeak IoT platform. Let's get started. So let me just explain you about the project that I'm going to build, and you can also build the same project until you achieve the same output that I got in my hardware. So the concept is simple. I will be having two node MCUs. One on the left is the transmitter node MCU and one on the right is the receiver node MCU. And I will be connecting both of these node MCUs to the router that is available in my home. And for having the internet access, I will be connecting this NodeMCU to the Wi-Fi router. And initially, to this TX NodeMCU, I will be interfacing a variable resistor to the analog channel of this NodeMCU. And I have already taught you how you can interface a variable resistor for fetching the analog step value using the analog channel available in the NodeMCU, right? So we are just going to use the same methodology for interfacing a variable resistor, and then I am just going to transmit the step value that I fetch from the analog channel of this node MCU directly to the cloud over here, that is to this ThingSpeak field available over here, continuously at a rate of 16 seconds. So as we did before, I am just going to transmit the analog step value continuously at a rate of 16 seconds per data. So once for 16 seconds, this node MCU will be reading the analog step value using the analog channel of node MCU, and then it will be transmitting the analog step value directly to the field that is available in my ThingSpeak server. So that's all about the process for first node MCU. Based on the knob rotation of my variable resistor, the step value that I'm transmitting will be varied. Once for each 16 seconds, the step values will be loaded to the field available in the ThingSpeak website. So that's all about the process for first node MCU. And the second node MCU is nothing but the receiver node MCU. So this is the IoT transmitter on the left, and on the right is the receiver node MCU. Here what I'm going to do is, I have already taught you to send a GET request for reading the latest updated data from the field of the channel available in the ThingSpeak, right? So we are just going to use the same program for reading the step value that has been loaded recently. So the last step value will be continuously read at an interval of 1 second by this node MCU. And if the step value is greater than 512, that is the 50% of the step value, I will turn on the LED, that is the blue LED available in this node MCU, which is defaultly connected to D0 pin of the node MCU. This LED available in the RX or receiver node MCU will be glowing, and when I pass the step value less than 512 by rotating the knob in the first node MCU, I will read the data and I will turn off the LED that is available in the second node MCU. So this is the project that I am going to build. So this is a completely a IoT based project. This will transmit the data, that is the node MCU available here will transmit the data to the field available here, and this will continuously read the data from the same field available over here in the thingspeak.com. So let's try to build this project. So now coming to our programming part, we are just going to write two different programs for two node MCUs. One is for the transmitter node MCU and another one is for the receiver node MCU. So as I said, this transmitter node MCU is useful for interfacing a variable resistor and then receiving the step value from the analog channel of node MCU, and then passing that step value that is received from the analog channel directly to the ThingSpeak server field available over here, right? So this is the process of transmitter IoT node MCU. So we have already written this program, right? I hope you remember the interfacing of variable resistor to node MCU, and then we wrote a program for passing the step value directly from our node MCU to the field right over here. So we have already tested it, and this is the program that we tested. I hope you remember this program, and I have provided this program in the download button below this video, and you can download it, and you just want to change the required fields like API key, field number, SSID and password of Wi-Fi router for running your program on your IoT device Node MCU. And if you are watching this video in the YouTube, you just want to enter my smtrainingacademy.com and then you just want to enroll for the required course, and each lecture is provided with a download button and you can use that download button for downloading the resources for that particular lecture. And now you can see, since I'm using the same field with the same channel ID, and the same field 1 for transmitting the step value, I'm not going to change anything in this program. I'm just directly going to upload this program to the transmitter device over here. So one of the Node MCU will be running this program that we have already created. So working of this program is very simple. It will be transmitting, it will be fetching the analog step value from the analog channel of Node MCU, and then it will be transmitting that step value directly to the field right over here by sending a GET request. So I have clearly explained about this program and we have built this program step by step in that lecture, right? So I hope you remember that. And this happens for every 16 seconds in this program. So for every 16 seconds, this analog step value will be read and it will be transmitted to the field right over here. So based on the knob rotation of the variable resistor, the step value will be changed and the changed step value will be transmitted to the field available over here in the ThinkSpeak server. So I am just going to upload this program to the transmitter Node MCU. And regarding these things, you can see this is the initial configuration of the program. This is the serial terminal initialization and this one is the connecting to Wi-Fi function. As usual, we are connecting the Node MCU to the router that is available in my home. So these are all the basic things that we will do usually. And other than that, I hope you remember this function also, which we wrote in the writing to a particular field in the ThinkSpeak website tutorial. So here we are just sending the GET request for writing the data to the field available over here. So these are all the functions that we have already discussed, but now we are just going to build a project using these programs for transmitting the data from our Node MCU and then for receiving the same data with this second receiving Node MCU. So this is a transmitter device and this one is the receiver device. So once the data is uploaded, that transmitted data will be printed on the serial monitor as per the statements written over here. The step value will be printed on the serial monitor, and now the program has been dumped to the Node MCU transmitter. Now we are just going to make the connection between the simplest analog sensor, variable resistor or potentiometer with our Node MCU development board. Now you can see this variable resistor is a 10 kilo ohms variable resistor which will be having the maximum resistance of 10 kilo ohms and it is having 3 terminals. So you can see, since this variable resistor is connected to breadboard, this rail over here is connected to the topmost terminal of the variable resistor, and this rail is connected to middle terminal of the variable resistor, and this rail is interconnected to the extreme right terminal of the variable resistor. So we are just going to use these three rails for connecting this variable resistor to the Node MCU development board. So I'm just going to connect the leftmost terminal of the variable resistor, that is over here, to the 3.3 volt signal of Node MCU. Here you can see I'm having a 3.3 volt signal pin that is available over here. I am just connecting this 3.3 volt to the leftmost terminal of the variable resistor. And regarding the middle terminal of the variable resistor, which is the analog out pin of the variable resistor, I am just going to connect it to the A0 pin of Node MCU. Here you can see this is the A0 pin, right? So I am just going to connect it over here. And finally, the rightmost terminal of the variable resistor,
that is available over here. You can see the rightmost terminal of the variable resistor. I am just connecting it to ground of NodeMCU. So here you can see I'm having a ground over here, Vin and ground. I'm just connecting it to the ground available over here. You can connect it to any ground in this NodeMCU, and I'm using this ground, and that's it. You can see the three terminals of the variable resistor. One on the left is connected to 3.3 volt right over here, and one on the middle terminal, which is the analog out pin of the variable resistor, is connected to A0 of the NodeMCU, and one on the right is connected to ground of NodeMCU. So that's all about the connections required, and let's see the output in the hardware.
And I'm opening the serial monitor. The NodeMCU is trying to connect to my Wi-Fi. Connection is done. Now you can see the step value is being uploaded to the ThingSpeak cloud field. You can see the 10 is transmitted. Again, 10 is transmitted after 16 seconds. I'm just changing this to be 2. Eighteen is the last data, 10 is the previous data. So from this we got to know that again 10 has been transmitted. Now you can see the fields take some time to update, or you can refresh this page. Now you can see 18 is the previous data and 10 is the latest data. So from this we get to know that our transmitter NodeMCU is working fine, and it is transmitting the step value that it is fetching from analog channel directly to this field available over here. I'm not changing anything in my variable resistor. That is why it is defaultly sending the analog value that is available in the analog channel. And regarding the receiver part, we know that we are just going to write a program in the receiver part for sending a get request for reading the latest updated data in this same field. So we have already done this, right? We have done this in the read from the channel lecture. That is, this is the program that we wrote, right? I have added this program also to the download button below this video. You can also download this. And now you can see this is the same program that we wrote in the read from a particular channel in the ThingSpeak server lecture. And in this program you can see we are just initializing the serial monitor, and then we are connecting it to the Wi-Fi, and then we are just using the same receive get request from channel 1 function for reading the field 1. So this parameter is the field number as we programmed. So we are just reading the field 1 available in the same channel, that is this channel ID 1400595. So the channel ID here is 1400595. So we are reading from the same channel. And now what we are just going to do is, here we are storing the data that we are fetching in a variable called result. So this result is nothing but a string variable, but we cannot check the string variable, right? So for that we just want to convert this variable type into integer or float. So I'm just declaring a float variable called result data, and I'm going to use this result data variable for converting the result that I got over here. So that can be done by writing result dot toInt function. So this method available over here is useful for converting the data type of the string to integer. So now if I get a value, for example, to be 10, this 10 will be converted from string to integer type by this line. So this 10 will be converted from string variable to integer variable by executing this line, and it will be stored in the variable result data, and that's it. and after that I am just going to print the result data variable onto the serial monitor that we are receiving. So this result string will be also printed along with the result data, and I don't want this response to be printed, that is why I have commented this line, but previously we have not commented this. And regarding the initialization part, we just want to configure the D0 pin, that is the LED pin, default LED pin available in the Node MCU as output, because we are just going to turn on the LED based on the step value that are transmitted from the transmitter Node MCU, right? So we are just configuring the LED pin as output. And then here I am just going to check the variable result data, which is having the data that we are receiving from this field in the format of integer. So I'm just going to check this result data. If it is greater than 512, which is the 50% value of the step value, so we know that the step value will be 0 to 1024, which is the 10 bit value. And if it is greater than 50% 512, I will turn on the LED. So for turning on the D0, I just want to make the pin low, right? So for turning on the LED, I just want to make the D0 pin low. So I'm just turning on the LED on. Else if it is less, I will turn off the LED. So I will make this same pin high. LED off. And that's it. You can see this will be continuously reading the latest updated data from the field right over here. And if it is having the value greater than 512, and then the string format is converted into integer, and after that it will print the data to the serial monitor, and once printed it will check for the condition if it is greater than 512, and if this condition is true it will turn on the LED, or if it is false it will turn off the LED. So this is the program required for receiver Node MCU that is available over here. So it will keep on reading the field over here with the latest updated data. If it is having a greater than 512 value, it will turn on the blue LED available in the Node MCU. Or if the value is less than 512, it will turn off the LED. So this is the program written over here for the receiver Node MCU. And I'm just going to upload this program to the Node MCU. I'm just connecting the second Node MCU. So if this result data is a string, then we cannot write this condition for checking the result data. So that is why we are just converting this result data or the result string available over here into integer format, and then we are storing that to the result data for checking the condition right over here. So we have not done this step in the previous lecture of reading the channel from ThingSpeak server, but here we are doing this just for checking the condition. You can use this technique for converting a string to number in the further programs you are writing. And the program has been successfully uploaded to my Node MCU, and let's test the output in the hardware by connecting both the Node MCUs. And that's it. You can see we have successfully uploaded the program for the transmitter Node MCU, and then we have successfully uploaded the program for receiver Node MCU, and our project has been completely built. And now I am just going to connect both the Node MCUs to my PC USB port for powering up, and then I am just going to connect a variable resistor to this Node MCU for sending a step value to the field, and we are just going to view the output of LED glowing when the step value here is greater than 512. And let's see the output in the hardware. And now you can see my hardware, that is, this is the transmitter Node MCU and this is the receiver Node MCU. So this is the IoT transmitter which will be fetching the data, that is the step value, from the analog channel of this Node MCU, and then it will be transmitting that analog channels once for 16 seconds to this field that is available over here in the ThingSpeak website. And then this NodeMCU, that is the IoT receiver, will be running the separate program which will be reading the latest updated data available in the same field available in the ThingSpeak website. So this field will be continuously read with an interval of 1 second with this receiver NodeMCU. So that is the program that is running here, and here we are running a program which will transmit the step value that is fetched from the analog pin of the NodeMCU to the field that is available in the ThingSpeak server. So we are running two different programs, and since the data that I am receiving over here is the maximum data, that is 10 bit value 1024, which is greater than 512 as per the logic written in the receiver part, the LED is turned on. And when I reduce the value by rotating the knob to make the value less than 512, the LED will be turned off. Since the writing process happens for once for 16 seconds, the process is a little bit slower, and now you can see the receiver IoT device turns off the LED because the value that we receive over here is only 12. Now when I again increase the value by rotating the knob, the LED will be turned on when the value becomes greater than 512. Now you can see I am getting the maximum value 1024, which is greater than 512, and that is why the LED in the receiver part is glowing. And again when I try to reduce the value by rotating the knob towards the ground, I get the LED turned off and the value now is 161 as per the serial monitor. And again when I increase the value, you can see 1024 is the maximum value, and now the value is greater than 512 and LED is glowing. And again when I rotate this to reduce the value, you can see the value is 9, which is less than 512, so the LED is turned off. Since this writing process happens for once for 16 seconds, this is little bit slower. And I have already mentioned that this is just a free account of ThingSpeak. It allows only writing once for 16 seconds to this fields available in the channel. Now the value is 1017, so the LED is turned on. So in this manner, you can program two different NodeMCUs, one acting as a transmitter of the IoT and other acting as a IoT receiver for controlling the LED. So you can build this project and demonstrate this if you have two NodeMCUs. So please try to build this circuit and demonstrate this project. See you in the next lecture. Thanks for watching.